Hey guys, Pondo checking in once again. Today is the 25th of August. It's 2015, the summer. Summer is almost over. It's almost September here in Southern California. Wanted to bring you guys another Garage Gym Athlete video. Give you a little bit of update of what's been going on in my lifting regimen, my lifting lifestyle. Today, as you can see here, I'm lifting with one of my best friends. His name is Ted. I've known him for more than a decade. We actually worked football together, worked out in football when I first started working out, way back when. Today's goal basically was just to get a feel of each other, see what our strengths are, see what our weaknesses are, see what we could learn from one another. That's a really good point to take home. Whether you're a CrossFitter, a bodybuilder, a cross-country runner, there's always something that you could learn from one another. To progress your game a little bit better also, if you have the right mentality going into the workout. We just did a lot of, we warmed up, as you've seen, we warmed up with the lat pull down, lat pulley. I love that piece, it's from Spud Inc. I did a review video on it if you guys wanted to take a look. But it's one of my favorite ways to warm up the upper body. That, dips, push-ups, or pull-ups, it really just opens up, my rib cage. My rotator cuffs and everything like that. I always like to warm up and get limber before I do bench press. I seem to get a lot of pain in my shoulders on the bench if I don't warm up properly or two, don't pinch my shoulders back and push from the lats to retract the weight into the lats and basically form a rubber band effect in order for me to push the weight back up. So I wanted to bring you guys a little bit of what I've been doing. Also, I've been focusing a lot. I know I haven't been doing a lot of videos recently, but I want to let you guys know that I've been focusing on a healthier diet. A quick spiel about what I've been doing. I've been eating a lot more, whole foods, organic foods. I get a lot of stuff from Costco, and I make like a blend, a juice blend. And I drink it 3 times a day. And ever since I've been doing that, in another video sooner or later, I'm gonna make a little explanation on what I do, but I feel so much better. Energy levels are up. The strength levels are up. Weight is down, I'm surprised. Calories are down, but my strength levels are up and energy levels are up. In comparison, my diet before I started, eating a healthier diet, focusing a lot more on vegetables and things like that, was I used to, when I had my girlfriend, we used to just eat out 6 days a week, if anything. And when we did stay home to eat, all we ate was eggs and bacon. I'm really starting to focus a lot more on dietary changes, more than just gym changes, just hopping on different, workout regimens, Cube, Candido, Shaco, whatnot. I noticed that, I've never really focused a lot on my healthy eating, but when I did, energy levels inside the gym and outside the gym is just so much more improved. I know it's so elementary, it's so basic, but it's something that have you guys not necessarily focused on yet. It's a great thing to take into account. My calorie count before, I would say, was roughly around 3,600 a day. Right now I'm probably getting in maybe 2,500. So I'm actually 1,000 calories less than I was when I was just a strict power lifter. But in all honesty, I feel like I'm getting a lot more micronutrients into my diet, so I'm feeling a lot more energetic, stronger, better. It's not just the calories also, and in my opinion also, it's the quality of food that you put in your body that gives your body, if you're basically putting in crappy fuel versus high quality fuel in your engine, I think it would make a difference. I don't know if there's an actual study correlating these two facts, but I feel that it's a great thing to take a look into. Anyways, more or less about my diet. I did lose, I was 220 pounds when I was in the Shaco cycle. Today, I was on this workout, I was probably like 209, 209.8. So I'm 10 pounds less. I feel slimmer. I feel more energetic, and it's very good. So the workout today, we did quite a bit of bench, as you have seen. We started off 5x5 on the bench. We just stuck to 225 and worked on our form. As you can see, my form is a little bit different than Ted's form. My form is more of a power lifter. I get a little bit of an arch, while Ted also just, he's more of a bodybuilder. He gets a lot of the strength from his chest and his triceps and his shoulders. I get my strength from my whole body. It comes from you know, those muscles, especially lats, especially the hamstrings, the core. And you know, my setup is a little bit differently. I tend to pinch my shoulder blades a little bit closer. I just do it that way because I feel it's a lot safer for my my structure, and I feel a lot less pain. You know, I'm almost I'm 28 years old now, and basically everything that I do in the gym, I first, you know, it has to pass kind of like a safety inspection to see whether or not it's best for me to use to do it like so, you know. Front squatting, back squatting, low bar squatting, deadlifting, sumo deadlifting. I usually go with the safest and what feels best for me. And I feel that, you know, it's gonna pay dividends in the long run. I intend to be lifting more than, you know, at least another 15 years, if not 20 to 30 years into the future. And some of my viewers are always responding to me, told me that, you know, I'm still very young at 28. Some of my viewers are over 40 and they're still hitting it hard. So more props to these guys who I look up to and definitely idolize and I want to be like one day. As you can see here, we're hitting the weight heavy. We're using the slingshot. It's a great piece of equipment. I absolutely do love it. There's a lot of different things I have in my gym, and slingshots is, you know, it's up there. It's one of my favorite tools. It definitely makes bench pressing fun. Bench pressing is not the most exciting workout, the most exciting lift in my opinion. But the more different equipment, you know, you could throw at it, the more different stuff that you have to make it more fun, the more you're gonna do it. So my top set today, I just used a slingshot. As you can see right here, I did 295. I didn't really want to push it any farther. I didn't want to go anymore. My goals are a little bit different now. I'm not necessarily going for numbers. I'm kind of like on an interim portion, like I'm in between goals. I was definitely going for strength in the past year, but at this point in time, I don't know if I've highlighted that in my recent video, but I feel like I really just want to focus a lot more on feeling good, feeling healthy, looking good, you know, basically looking lean, and also being able to function the way my body looks. I want to go down to 190 pounds. I was 220, so I was going to lose 30 pounds in total. I'm down 10, and you know, it's going pretty well. Anyways, guys, that was a long vlog post about what's been happening and what I want to do. But anyways, thanks you guys for watching. Thank you guys for being subscribed to my channel. To everybody that's new, I'm gonna try to put out as much content as I can. I want to do some more product reviews before the end of the summer. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. Please do like, share, and subscribe, and I will catch you guys on the next lifting video. Peace.